answer. Hello, Sullivan.
Good morning, Brother Grimley. Do you copy me loud and clear?
You sound great. Go for it. I'll go mute.
Thank you very much for your kindness. And please answer your phone when I call you tonight, around 9 p.m. your time. I have pen and paper ready to write, and I will use my last tokens to talk to you 2 minutes. I embrace my siblings and go where I left. I said the Jew military hive mind and its extended family conditioning you to worship your overlords in any costume because they always shape-shift their appearances permanently. They gain control over you by miscegenation and tampering your DNA, and I'll always mention epigenetics. There is a growing mongrel race, a cursor of the complete enslavement due transhumanism, and they conquer your body. They already conquer your mind by mind control, and they are completing the soul-heart unit takeover by fate, fascination, and fear. And most of the population, even maybe you yourself, don't see it. You are not as you were 40 years ago anymore. You are not a man or a woman. You resemble one, but you are a replica, a defective copy. And many thought the movie Body Snatcher was fiction. They count with you as gullible in permanent denial. Just take a look in the mirror and you can see your pale, rancid skin, your baldness, your brittle hair, growing hair, ear rolls, falling teeth, double chin, congestive eyelids, hammer toes, fungi toenails, flabby arms, humongous belly, arthritic hands. Let me give you another factual. You are not aging. You are mutating. A replica, a mutant, not a woman or a man anymore. My brother always emphasized, find a wrong to make it right, and I judge his words without any hesitation or mental reservation. I am doing this all along my journey, and the response to my effort is frustrating and more than disappointed. I know I don't have immense lore that Al has the law of the land and money law and all the legal venues that should guarantee our success fighting and defending our lives. I wonder if Al had his actual expertise about their procedures. He had then defeated the military state when it attacked him in the middle of the woods where he tried to isolate himself. I truly subscribe to the concept that as much as some siblings read and quote the Constitution, the codes, the laws, etc., and making them valid and applicable, they should also give at least the rank of notice to all the white papers the psychopaths rub on our faces. I have always presented the white papers as evidence. I avoid it permanently, hearsay and speculation. So our siblings should learn what shapeshifters are enacting since ever. The evidence is in the so-called sacred text, in the Zohar, in the Pentateuch, the Quran, etc. In public wars, from psychopath militants like in power, like where Roosevelt and Wilson and Washington and Howard and many more, coming from rabbis like Henry Wharton, and Obadiah Youssef, Sholom Rubansky, Ben Gurion, etc., Bill Gates, come back from your ladder on oblivion. I see the battle for battlefield war is manipulated all in by then, because the euphemistical expression conflict of interest among our civilians is real law. We are infiltrated and surrounded by collaborators, Chavez goals, traitors, docile pets of the military power. And until your siblings or siblings detach themselves from such a corrosive parasite, our efforts make them accountable for good. Unfortunately, as he admits since long time ago, it is an effort. And my humble take along and make it right is completely cut all your ties with the family ties, the associate with anyone in the military state. Make it very clear. It is only real step to reach awareness. We all see the progress when broadcasters stop calling police state, when they know we live under martial law de facto. The shapeshifter in costumes are not police because they are not peace officers. Until then, it is only cosmetic, even so.
Uh-oh. They got him. See here.
They cut me off. Thank you very much, brother. Thank you, siblings, and I will try to reach you this night. Please, answer the phone.
All right. Thanks, Solomon.
Thank you, brother. Thank you.
All right. All right. Well, that was Solomon. He's going to call tonight with some kind of information. I don't know what that'll be, but I'll try to be ready for him with a pen and paper handy, as he requested. We'll see what he's got to say. But for now, my fellow mutants, yes, you are all mutants. You're being mutated by the militaristic martial law, a.k.a. police state. No, not police state. Military state that you live under. Thank you, Solomon. I'll be looking forward to your call this evening and hopefully next week. Now it's back to the blues. Little Taj Mahal here. And interestingly, we're on a song called Don't Call Us.